back to another Lefties 2 broadcast. Today, we are focusing in on our common pitchers. Right? Now, I have individual videos for each of Erik, James, and Michelle. Right? But I want to give you guys a little insight with all three of them, because lately I've been seeing so many people in like the Facebook groups talk about, like, how do you get your pitchers to 13? How do you do it? So for those of you that have been watching these videos and understand the game, all right, it's not for you. This is for the new people that are trying to get better. So first, we're going to start off with Erik here, all right? And just to kind of give you an insight how Erik works, right, he has that cutter. That's his typical fastball. And he has a four-seam fastball. That's straight. And again, it has that like big swooping curveball. For those of you that are new in this game, right, you could play the game or you can just throw strikes down the pipe. The concept is to win the game, right? Herman Edwards. We play to win the game. So understand how the pitches work and what they're trying to do. It's like a chess match. You're trying to set up the pitcher, right? You're trying to set up the pitches and try to set up the batter. So understand, Erik's right-handed. His four-seam fastball is straight, right? Okay, his cutter is going to move to the outside, inside, outside to right-handed batters. And so what should you do? Should you throw the cutter down the plate? No. It's probably right here, like here. Throw it outside a little bit, right? Throw it outside. Make the batter chase. Change it up a little bit. Cutter, four seam. You got to use some movement. Okay? The curveball, this thing, you want to use it as just something to deceive. Right? Don't throw curveballs in the strike zone. They're slow. Right? You want the curveball to be able to complement the fastball. Okay? Pretty simple. All right, so let's move on to Michelle. Okay? Let's see what Michelle has to offer. And just, again, we're trying to create this. Again, I don't have a great ERA. It's 7-8. I'm terrible with her. But yet, 90 and 36, it's close to 75%. She's probably my worst common pitcher. But again, I didn't get her leveled up until I was already in the higher levels. Okay? But she's great. And if you pair her up with Jessica as a catcher, that two strikes, that little cursor is going to shrink. Right? So again, all the common pitchers are right-handed. Right? What does that do? It's in real baseball, being left-handed is, you know, an advantage. Not as many. The ball comes out a little differently. I don't really care either way in this game. But again, Michelle, she's a great pitcher to use if you're starting out. Right? Don't be afraid of the gray cards. Right? The gray cards, they're there for a reason. Right? There's videos in the past where I have common cards. What are the best common cards to use? If you're starting out, you get more common cards than you do rare, epics, and legendary. And now, the fact that there's over 76 cards in the deck, what are you doing, right? Use the cards that are available, level them up, because again, when you level them up, they are going to give you gold back. Once you max them out, they're going to give you gold, and if you get a lot of common cards, that little bit of gold is going to add up over time, especially if you're new and you're trying to play a lot, right? I have two accounts. The 34161, I don't pay for anything on that account. I don't pay the monthly fee. I just worry about my lineup and I try to just get one card at a time. It takes a long time, right? That's what's going to happen. So you figure out your lineup and go after those particular cards. Okay? But Michelle, she's a great pitcher to use. You got that fastball. She's got the curveball. She's got the slider. A lot of breaking balls. All right, last pitcher, James. Again, James, he's the first level 13 pitcher I had. I use this guy. I've been using him for 2 years. Okay? Three pitches. Fastball, Slider, changeup, right-handed bat, a right-handed pitcher. What is he going to do? You don't throw complete strikes all the time. You got to be deceiving with it with every pitcher, not just the common ones. Okay? You're trying to win the game. So take this two-seamer, right? Throw it off the plate. Widen the batter's eye a little bit. Outside, inside. High, low. Corner, corner. All right. Most of the players that are all level 13s, we know how people are typically in a pitch. And we can kind of figure it out over time. Now it's just about, can you hit it? Can you catch up with it? But when you're level 10, 11, 12, you got to use deception more. The ball is obviously slower, less spin, less movement. So if you're throwing breaking balls in the strike zone that are slow and you're playing, oh my God, these level 13 players, yeah, it sucks. The algorithms suck. If you get on a winning streak, you get cut down really quick. But the best way to move up, if you want to move up fast, which I don't necessarily recommend moving up too fast. Sorry, I don't recommend it. Because you're going to run into people that are all level 13s. And they're all pretty good. Okay? But the concept is, right, with James, I like to use that changeup on the outside corner to righties. Not a lot of lefties in this lineup I have. But, again, all the pitchers are right-handed, so it's kind of talking more about that. But that in baseball, they talk about getting ahead of the count faster, right? Get a strike. So a lot of people, they're going to throw way outside. It's going to make you look out there, right? It's changing your perception, changing your eye level, changing the speeds. But the main point of this whole video is just to kind of show you guys common cards are not bad. Right? They're not. The gray cards, it's just marketing, right? Gold, shiny. Oh, shiny and purple. Oh, shiny and blue. Oh, gray and boring. There are a lot of great gray common cards in this game. Level them up as fast as possible. Get better. And see you next time on a Lefties 2 Broadcast.